Hi everyone, my name is Federico Tartarini and in this video I just want to show you how you can automate the process of exporting the results from a survey in Qualtrics. We are going to use Python as a programming language and we're going to use several packages to do that, and I will show you step by step how to write the code. I will also share with you the code on GitHub, as well as we'll show you how to activate the token on Qualtrics and how to leverage Qualtrics API. Okay, so here we are inside Qualtrics. This is my survey. I'm in the data and analysis tab. I can click on export and import to download the data. So I can click here, export data, and I can download the data in CSV. However, this is the manual process and this is slow. And every time I have new responses, I need to click this button again and perform the action over and over. So we can leverage the Qualtrics API and Python to perform this task automatically. Okay, we can see that we have 14 responses and I will show you that we can download that data on our computer very simply and we're going to get the same results. So what do we need to do? First, we need to click here at the top where we have this icon here. We need to go in account settings, click there. Then we need to go in Qualtrics IDs. Okay. I will blur this page because I don't want you to show you my private keys. However, you will see that there is a button that says generate token. Please click that if you have not generated a token before. However, if you have already generated a token, please do not generate a new code. Otherwise, the new code will replace the old one. Under the survey tab, here there is a table with the surveys. From there, you will have to extract the survey ID. So look on the left side, the name of the survey, the name of the survey that you want to get the data from. And on the right side, you should find the survey ID. We start with SV underscore. So copy all that one, and we will copy that into the Python code. Finally, so we have gotten the token, the survey ID. Finally, you will need the organization ID and the data center ID. Okay, I will show you how and where to enter those two information. So let me enlarge a little bit here PyCharm and I will show you the code step by step. So we will first need to import these packages, which generally come with your installation of Python. So technically you don't have to install anything else. And again, I will put a link in the description of the video to the GitHub repository. I first have to say that I need to thank this guide here, which you can find at this link here. And there is a post in which they have uploaded all this Python tool or this Python code that I'm actually using in this video to show you how to automate the process. Okay. We are defining a function here. The function has two input, the directory where we want to save the data and the survey ID. And I previously told you how to get the survey ID. Okay, so when we're going to call this function, we're going to put the directory where to save the data. In my case, it's going to be download in downloads folder and the survey ID, which is the information that you got before. Then we need to specify the API token. Okay, the API token, you can get it from the previous tab in your browser and you can paste it here. Okay, this is going to be a long string of text. So either uncomment this line and delete this one. I've saved all this information into a Python file called MySecrets, just because I don't want to show you my secret token. And then finally, so we have input the survey ID, the API token. Finally, we need to put the data center information. And the data center is a combination of the two information that we just got before. The data center here that we need to provide is actually the organization ID period the data center ID. Okay, so this is a little bit confusing. So here your will look like something like a string of organization ID period data center ID. Okay, now that we have entered all the input parameter, now we need to set up our URL. Okay, we need to set up the progress to zero, progress status in progress, and we need to specify the base URL. Here, why is important? This is where it's important to have the proper data center, because this data center is going to be entered here into the string. Okay, of the base URL. Then we have the headers here, in which we specify the API token. Then we are going to create the base URL, okay? So the base URL will contain information about the file format, which in our case is going to be CSV, and the survey ID that we actually want to get the data from, okay? Each survey will have its unique survey ID. Then using the requests package in Python, we're going to do a post request in which we are going to download the data, and we are getting and updating the process, the progress ID. We're using this while loop to wait for the responses to be ready, and then we download the file on our computer. Okay, using the request get, and we download the file once it's ready. Finally, the last step is to use zip package to unzip the file, and then we print that the download of the Qualtrics survey was successful. Okay, here is where I'm actually running the code, so you don't really need this part here, if name equal to main. This is just if you're running this file, you can actually, let's actually remove this one for the moment, and let's actually indent the code properly. So this is the path where we're going to save the file. In my case, I want to save it in the downloads, and here I'm calling the function. So as I previously mentioned, I need to specify the path and the survey ID. So if I go into my download folder, so here we are. Okay, so we can see that currently there is no, that survey is not being downloaded. So let's do Control A, Shift Alt E. This only works, of course, in PyCharm. If you're using another IDE, you can use another shortcut to run your code. And as you can see here right now, we have all our responses. So these are all my responses in Excel. So let me open them. So here we can open all my responses, and let me open also the project. So let me go into the project, just one second. I have it here on my second screen. So here, okay, I go in data analysis. Let me bring it up here. So as you can see, here we have all the 14 responses, count 14. As you can see here, there are 14 responses, and you can see all the respective date, the relative dates. So we have the start date was the 17th 02 2021 at 11:51. Actually, that's the start date, and this is the end date. Okay, so this way is extremely helpful and extremely quick to perform this action, and you can perform this action multiple times. So if now I complete a survey, I can run the Python script again, and all the data will be downloaded automatically on my computer. I really hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please consider liking this video and subscribing to my channel. And if you have any question or comments, please just leave them down below under the video. Thank you very much for listening.